Hello, Ignite Army, God's Army. Happy New Year. Welcome to 2022. As I've sat with God and waited and watched with Him for His plan for your new year, God says, this year is the year of the caveman. But what does that mean? God said that you are a people. You are the ones that I've preserved, that I've watched, that I've guarded with jealousy, that I love you and I have a plan for you. And in this year, you will begin to see the fruition and the fruit of that plan. God says, I am calling you out of the cave, out of the place of darkness where it feels like you have been living for far too long, where it feels like you're in a place of obscurity, where it feels like you've been in a place where you can't begin to even see yourself, yet alone the places in front of you, where it feels like you've been in a place where you haven't begun to even hope or imagine what it is that God wants to do in your life, where you felt incapable, where you felt weak, where you felt like you haven't had the giftings or the ability or the capacity to do anything of any means or effect. God said, I have called you to have great impact. And now I'm calling you out into that. Yes, you've been in a place of recluse. Yes, you've been in a place of obscurity. But I've been protecting and hiding you there, hiding you under my rock, hiding you in my presence. I have been keeping you while it feels like so many have fallen by the wayside. But now I am calling you out into that light. I am calling you into that place of emergence. But realize this, in that place, if you are going to step out and live and manifest in that light, you must be prepared. In the same way that Elijah did, when the Bible says that he had called forth and the rain had come, and Ahab began to run towards Jezreel, it says that Elijah girded his loins and he ran with full pelt and he ran past Ahab. God wants you right now to prepare yourself. He wants you to be prepared. He wants you to gird up your loins and prepare for the place that He is taking you. In this year, God says that I will prepare you, I will manifest you, I will call you into light. But I need you to be prepared. I need you to keep your eyes on me. I need you to remain focused and keep sturdy on my word. In the same way that he said it to Jeremiah, he said, prepare yourself to go out and to speak that which I have called you to speak, to do that which I have called you to do, to tear down that which I have called you to tear down, and to build up that which I have called you to build. This is a year where you're going to have to show your resilience, where you're going to have to be strong, because there's never no opposition where it comes to the works of God. When God has called you to a thing, it will come with turmoil. It will come with challenges. But God said, I have fortified you. I need to realize that you are a fortified people. You are surrounded by my light. You are surrounded by my fire. And so in this new year, in this year of the caveman, in this year where you find yourself where the people that have been underestimated, where the people that have been undermined, they are the people that will shine in this year. They are the people that would have greater impact. They are the people that would have great resilience and will have great strength. They are the people that will see the power that I've put on the inside of them. It's the same way the Holy Spirit has let you know that His hand shall be upon you. When Elijah began to gird his loins, the Holy Spirit came upon him and gave him the steam and the strength to run with great speed. And in the same way He put His hand upon you now, He says, my spirit and my hand shall be over you in this new year. It shall strengthen you. It shall give you all provision and all requirements that you need to be able to walk in all I have called you to. He says, the hand of my spirit will be ever upon you. In the same way my hand was upon David when it was time for him to play for the king. God says that in this place that I am taking you to, my hand is going to be steady upon you. And while it seems as if you might be of no position or esteem, I'm going to elevate you by the power of my spirit. And in this new year, you shall see that the last shall truly be the first, and the first shall truly be the last. And God said, I am going to use this year to turn the tables. And this year is the year for my generation. This is the year for the youth. This is the year where young people shall rise up like never before. God said, in this year, I'm going to show you that I will use what the world calls wisdom and considerate foolishness. And what the world calls foolishness, I shall show you that there is great wisdom in it. This is your year. Gird up your loins, strengthen yourself. Continue to keep your eyes fixed upon the Lord and watch what He will do for you. God is translating you from darkness into light. He is translating you from lack into wealth. He is translating you from weakness into strength. He is translating you from bad into good. He is taking you to high places. I trust God for the testimonies that are going to come through this year. But one thing is essential. You must gird your loins. You must prepare. You must stay fixed with your eyes upon Him and watch His hand do great things with you. God bless you. Happy New Year.